but we're just going to review again how to subtract and ungroup. One, we're going to look at a problem that looks like this. We have 1,353.
And again, for your, I don't know if we mentioned it, but make sure you put this down. This will be sort of the vocab thing to put down, is the type of subtraction, place by place, right to left, and then the step by step, just so you have that to go back to when you have to solve your own problems.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. I got so excited. I just want to get right into it. So we have 1,353 minus 769. When we are going right to left, we're going to start over here in the ones place value. And we are going to look and think, okay, can I do 3 minus 9? No. Please say no. And then if you say no, you have to borrow from next door at the tens place. So we're going to do that right here. So now instead of 5 tens, we have 4 tens, which means now our 3 can turn into a 13. Mm-hmm. So now we can do 13 minus 9, and we will get 4, hopefully. Then we have to look again now in our tens place, and we have to ask ourselves, can I do 4 minus 6? No. Once again, please say no. And you are going to then borrow in the next place value, which is hundreds. Now, what you'll notice is we're just adding on. We had 4 tens, but now since we realized we can't do 4 tens minus 6 tens, we're borrowing yet again. We're just showing you that this is another step. Mm-hmm. So now we have 2 hundreds, and we can bring over our other group of 10, so now we have 14 here. So we can do 14 minus 6. So now we have 84 total. Now we're going to look here at our hundreds place value, and hopefully by now you're realizing, no, I cannot do 2 minus 7 hundreds. So that's going to turn into our step 3. Mm-hmm. Once again, borrow from the next place value. So instead of 1,000, we're borrowing from there, and so now we can have 12 hundreds minus 700. So, whew, with all that crossing off and ungrouping, we should end up with 584.
You know, I used to have a teacher that had a poem that she taught me that was bottom bigger, better borrow. Say so if the bottom is bigger, you better borrow.
Oh, I like that.
That helps you think about it. But so now it's your turn to try some. So we want you to write this down in your journal. Again, please remember the importance of lining them all up correctly. And attempt it, pause this, try this, and then come back, and we will show you how to do it. Okay, so the first step, we're looking at our ones place. So I cannot take 6 from 4, right? So I have to ungroup my next column over, my tens column. So rather than having 8, I now have 7 tens, and those 10 extras I got come over here, and we've got 14. So 14 take away 6 is what I'm going to end up with, and I believe the answer is going to all come up at the end. Mm-hmm. So now I do 7 minus 4. Well, can I do that? Yes.
Yes.
You Yay. Can take 7 minus 4. So now I'm looking at my next column over. 3 take away 9. 9 is bigger. Have to borrow. So I ungroup my thousands place, which leaves me with 4 thousands, and now I have 13 hundreds. Can I do 13 minus 9? Yes. 4 minus 8? No. So ungroup my 4 10 thousands, leaves me with 3, and now I have 14 thousands minus 8, which I can do. So when you go through and have all these subtracted out, you end up with 36,438. So hopefully you got that.
Big numbers.
Mm-hmm. And now it's your turn. So pause this, write this down, and try and solve these questions, please. And we'll take a look at those when you come in with your summaries tomorrow.
We were just talking about whole numbers. Now we get to talk about decimals and how we can subtract those as well. Is remember, when we are dealing with decimals, we have to align the numbers with the correct place value. So yep. Thinking back to when we were learning about decimals and where the tenths are and hundredths are, we really need to think about that again. And subtract these decimals with me. The easiest way is about, we have our 4/10 here, or 0.4, but now that we're smart about decimals, we can say 4/10. And we want to subtract 2/100. When we really take the time to line up our zeros and our decimals and any numbers after our decimals, we realize it's not just 4 minus 2. We're really looking here and we have 4/10, and we want to subtract 2/100 from that.
But there's nothing there. There's nothing. It's just 4.
Right. So what we can do, though, is we can add a little zero there. Okay? And that zero is like a placeholder. And it also just lets us think about, well, okay, I have 40/100. And that's a whole lot easier to subtract from 2/100.
Mm-hmm.
So that zero is really helpful. It's a placeholder. It can also just help us out when we're subtracting and adding.
After the decimal point, you could probably add zeros forever, and it wouldn't really change the value. So
yeah.
You could add as many as you need to. But in this case, we only need one.
Yep. So now I'm going to look and say, okay, 0 minus 2, can't do that again. So I have to ungroup to the left here. And I can borrow from my tenths. So instead of 4/10, I now have 3/10.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm instead of 0, I can make this 10/100. So 10 minus 2 should give us 8. Now I just have to look here and say 3 minus 0 gives us 3 and plug in our decimals and zeros.
Mm-hmm.
So we should have an answer like this instead of 2.
Well, and if you think about it too, the way you say it, 40/100. Minus 2/100. 40 minus 2 is 38. I mean, it's just another way to think about
right.
it, too.
Right.
Okay. All right. So, remember this little trick? Are you ready to be amazed again? So, if you need to line up your decimals again and line them up nicely, and this works with big numbers, too. It doesn't just have
yeah.
to be decimals.
Right.
Turn your paper sideways. All right. So, here. Woo! I didn't know I was going to do it twice. So, we've got 8/10 minus 73/100. So again, there's nothing here, nothing after the 8. But like we said, you can add zeros on forever and it will be not change the number. So we add a zero on, and this makes it a lot easier to subtract. So 80/100 minus 73/100. So our first step, I can't take 3 away from 0. If I don't have anything, I can't take 3 away from it. So I have to ungroup my tenths place, which leaves me with 7/10. Now I have 10/100. So 10 take away 3 I can do, and it ends up with 7. And then if you look at the rest, 7 minus 7 is 0. 0. My decimal came down, so 80/100 minus 73/100 is 7/100.
Mm-hmm.
All right. These, how many do we have? These are ones for you guys to try. Sorry, my dog's making noises too. All right, so remember when you are doing these ones on your own. Everyone say hi to Shadow. when you do these ones on your own, remember to line up the decimals on your paper. Line up the decimals on your paper. Add zeros if you need to, and then try and solve them. Good luck.